Today we'll not be really getting into coding today too. I'll show you in what situation you'll use what IDEs. Like yesterday people were asking me why am I doing this CMD and writing Python. Okay, I uninstalled Python because I use Jupyter anyway. I just forgot that. So when you have this Python IDE, if I have it, okay, I removed it. Let me install it for them. Python. Okay, skip that. Let's go to python.org. For people who haven't installed Python, this can be a what we can say, revision or the skip lecture thing. You can actually use. Am I audible to you people? Just quickly tell me in the comments. So. So we are not getting any comments. Am I not audible? Add to path and then we go to the next. Oh. There are no comments. Am I not audible? Can anyone tell me, am I audible or not? Okay, there has to be some issue in this. I think something is wrong with my Python right now. Anaconda. Python. No, it's not running. You can select. Who else is excited for today? Python live event. I am excited. Commenting is on, right? For everyone. I don't see any comments yet. So, solution is almost done. लो आ रहा है ओके आई ट्राई टू इंक्रीज माय वॉल्यूम दिस इज ऑलमोस्ट ओके वी आर डन सो सीएमडी Python. Okay, it's installed. So people were asking me why do you prefer this for experiments. So yes, everything has its own thing. Like when you want to make a little experiment, like I want to see if this works. Print hello. Let's do Bnorm. People are asking. So it prints Bnorm. Now this is a one line experiment, right? If I want to do one line experiment, some small things I wanna see if this thing works or not. If it is a one line thing, I'll do it in this 3 MD thing, because look, here I don't have to open an ID, I have to write, save it and then run. As an hour I do this Python and I can just start. So for this little experiment, I do not want to do more stuff or more work. What you can also do is Windows R, you can write Python here itself and it works. So let's start with today's topic. Today it was why we would use what kind of ID for what work purpose. So you have this Python ID, right? Okay, now this is Anaconda. Python ID, do you not have a Python? Yes, Python ID. Audible doc, Python ID. Okay, it seems that's my ID right now. So let's start with a VS Code. So all of you have to install this software. It's called Visual Studio Code. The download link is right here. You can just download and install it. This has no critical instructions for me to show it by installing it for you. Like Python had a critical instruction, if you do not do that add path thing, it would never work in other directories. It would just work in the directory you are. So just download it from here. I have downloaded it here. Then you can actually start with installation and you're good to go. Other than that, Windows R, CMD. Make sure your Python is installed with Jupyter Notebook. So Jupyter, Jupyter, Notebook, Jupyter Notebook. So as you type this, a server runs inside. This is a part of Python, okay? This is not a different thing. This comes with Python. A server starts running and your browser will open up. So let's open this in GX, okay? Here we go. So this part of Python. So when you do big experiments, like check build course, you wanna try new things, but bigger things, like not a one liner thing, you will open this Jupyter Notebook. It is called as Jupyter Notebook. So there is this new option, select Python 3, click on this. This opens a whole new world of seamless experiments. So in here, if you see, this is just one line. And as you start typing, like I want to print something, yes. Also, you can see if you write print here, when you put the first bracket, it automatically puts the second bracket for you, the closing bracket. When you put double quotes, it automatically puts the double quotes on the right hand side. So, much of your typing is reduced and more of your experimenting thing is increased. Let's type something plus. Something else. So this was concatenation, what I actually taught in the last lecture. If somebody had missed this, this is a string and this is a string. I can put a plus sign between them and just print them. Also, when you add two strings, like one string and second, make sure you put either a space here or a space here, because when you add it, it does not put extra space. So you have to put, like if I backspace this, see the something, and after that there is no space. So either I last time I put it here, this time I'll put it here. So something else. Anything you write here, like let's do a for loop today. Like, no, let's print something. People, all people would not know for loop. So anything you type, you have to do shift and enter. When you do shift and enter, the command runs. And you can see the number of lines you have consumed. 1 line, 4 line, 5th line. Why 4 line? Because I ran this thing thrice. So that code is already stored. If I say x is equal to 1, shift enter, this x is equal to 1 is stored. If I print it anywhere, print x, so the number of lines are same, but you can experiment with whatever, whenever, whichever line you want, and the code that is previously run or the previously compiled code would already be there, and you can actually experiment with it. So this is a great thing to experiment. So for beginners, I would actually tell you to experiment in this thing, because see here, you do not have to open a new tab every time. You do not have to open a new project every time, a new file, save it, then run it. That is some boring task. I don't want you to do boring stuff. I want you to learn. I want you to experiment. The more you experiment, the more you will grow. So this is Jupyter notebook. Once again, I'll show you how to open this. Also make sure whenever you close this thing, close this from here, file, close and hold. If you don't do this, you see no kernel. This is a server. So every time you run a new notebook, a whole new server is made, idealized, and then it starts. Then quit this. You can see all that I am doing right here is shown. Like after it started, the kernel started, the file got saved, there was a buffer, some memory was taken, the kernel was shut down, as I shut it down, the API was shut down, and then zero kernel, so the kernel shut down. That's all. So again, let's go Windows R CMD. Okay, I'll increase the font of CMD, as someone said last time. Font 36. Okay, so now you can actually see what I'm typing. So Jupyter, Jupyter, notebook, Jupyter notebook. Press enter. Wait for a while. It will show you. So here's the page. After that, you can either do new, or you can go down, and here is, this is the file right, that I opened last. It is untitled because I did not put a title last time. So let's click here. Let's see if the file is saved, or if what experiments I did was saved. See, and also it is to the point where you actually halted it. So all these lines are already run, like they are already executed, and now you can start experimenting from where you left. Or you can do one thing. There is this thing called cell all output clear. So you, as and how you clear all the output, then you started running from here. 1, 2, 3. So now you can see this is line 1, line 2, line 3, because this is how I executed it. If I do anything here, this is line 4. You can see it, like. So you can do n number of lines here, you can do anything you want, and you know, just experiment with things. Experimenting is when you learn, right? Hope it is visible. Okay, so it is visible. Okay. So here, also, you can add a title to the notebook. For supposing, I'll add this as basic. So I renamed this to basic. Control S, whenever you do Control S, auto save. Now you can see the file is here. Yes, all the files that are shown on the home page of Jupyter. If this shows green, that means you have forgotten to close the book. I'll show you. If I close this directly without doing this close and halt, if I close this directly, this is still green, running. This server is running yet. it is just consuming our RAM and resources, and you are not utilizing it. So close it. You can also close it from here, I think. Now you have to again go in there and close it. So file, close and halt. Yes, see, now it is closed, so it is not showing green right now. Also, when you close this, quit. Always quit. Close. So here again, whatever we did is shown here. It is a kernel, right? And you can open n number of notebooks in there. N number of notebooks. There is no limit to the number of notebooks you use. So why is Kotlin now? No. Oh, there is some issue with Cortana. So, this is what I was trying to tell you, that everything has a different experimenting style. If you want to just experiment with one liner, control R, CMD, Python, one liner, whatever you want to put it, just put it here. Also, there is a Python IDLE. But it seems missing in my installation, I don't know why. Module manual, no, that's not. Also, if you really wanna make big projects, for suppose a big project, like there are 10 notebooks, there are many experiments, then there is a bigger thing that you can install. It is called Anaconda. Anaconda is like Python ka bada bhai Anaconda. The name is given that way only. So yes, let's open Anaconda. The opening is too cool. Like the Anaconda server opens. There would be a circle around the DevOps logo. Yeah, this I feel this is totally cool. This is how all the software should open. Anaconda takes time in running because it is a very bigger part of what you can say coding environment. When I say environment, this is itself a kind of a OS. Like it has its own accomplishment of RAM, its own memories, its own all the things, GPU utilization, all the things are reserved. A part of it is reserved. If your PC has 4 gigs of RAM, it reserves 2 gigs of RAM for itself. So as my PC is running OBS, I think, okay, it opens. So this is Anaconda, right? Here you can see many things, Jupyter Lab, notebook. You can open notebook directly, lab, PowerShell prompt, Qt console. We'll go through all this, don't worry. So there is a link to open VS Code too. So you can debug the code there if you are very familiar. So let me show you what Jupyter Lab does. Yeah, virtualization, you can totally do virtualization in this. It is, as I said, it is a total server based concept. Jupyter Lab. So as I said, Jupyter Notebook is just a notebook where you can do n number of experiments. This is Jupyter Lab. Here you can do so much more than what Jupyter Notebook can do. You can do it. You can see this. I created all this just to, you know, so that you can learn a quality level of Python as far as it is from my end. So here you can see there are many things. You can see the names too. So this is syntax, loops, types. All this we are gonna learn. So the best part about using Jupyter Notebook is. Okay, someone is PY ka bada bhai dank. Yes. So introduction packages. Okay. So let's open a file. Let's say types. So you can see this is a notebook opening in this lab. So this is bigger than notebook. So you can see you can actually make such things that are self-explanatory. Self-explanatory. Okay, Python for developers, all those things. We are gonna go through this. So you can actually see n number of things in here, and you know, I can open n number of tabs. Like this one is open, I can open the second one, the third one, and you know, you can learn many things whenever you are doing this. The best part about this is whenever you close it, it directly shuts the thing down. You don't have to close and halt. And why I want you to switch to notebook, the best thing is, suppose, let's take it off. So again, as this is to a server based thing, we'll shut this down. Always remember, shut things down if they are server based or your data can be lost. Again, Anaconda will quit it. So if you have Jupyter notebook, for now I'll tell you to see Jupyter. Okay, Anaconda 3. Shit. Okay, maybe this is just the Jupyter notebook part. Let's see. Okay, it is a notebook. So as you can see, here it is a notebook. And supposedly I send you some notes in IPYNB form. IPYNB is Python notebook. What is I? I don't remember much. Okay, Python notebook. So if I send you this book, whatever we have written here, you can actually directly implement it if you have this notebook. So when I send you a notebook file, let me tell you how you will do it. So Windows A is a command to open your files. Here I have saved my data of Python. So this was my notes from the last lecture. So supposing I send you this IPYNB file, right? Introduction IPYNB file. And you have this Jupyter open here. So what you can do is, you can catch this thing. You can go to browser. You can go to this and just come and move it here. So here the it is showing that there is a file that came from somewhere and it's named this, and it is a IPYNB, a Python notebook. So do you want to upload it or cancel it? So upload it. As and how you upload it, you will see it is here. So when you click on this, so it is been converted from other formats. Obviously it was an old notebook. So you can see, you can actually access it directly here. And these codes that I'll give you, always do this one good thing: cell output, clear the output. So now it will start from zero, no pre-executions. So as you actually open this notebook, you don't even have to write the code. It is just given here, and you have to do shift enter, and then you will see what happened here. Missing call print. Okay. So you can see this was a Python 2 notebook. As I said, Python 2 had no round brackets. But Python 3 has, so you have to put those. Maybe I'll modify it for you people. Okay, so instrument principle. So here it goes. Okay, print instrument. Okay, sorry. It was the variable instrument. Instrument, shift enter. Okay, so for today, let's learn what this code does, right? So this kind of execution for first line, let's do it in another notebook. I want to do it in another notebook. Like, why should I, directly run from the given notebook? I am a self-learned person. So, okay, all these things you can do. You can on a line, if you want to delete it, you can press D, the alphabet D, 2 times, and it will delete it. So let's see, instruments is equal to this. Okay, I'll copy this because I don't want to write it. Control V, shift enter. Okay, instruments have three values: bass, drums, guitar. So for instrument in this is just for today's purpose, like just something you can learn from here. This is not a loop lecture, it will be later. This is just to show you how you can actually work on this. So also one thing, do not shift enter when you want the space. Sometimes it happens with me because I have this habit of shift enter whenever I am using the notebook. So enter careful. Instrument print. So for instrument, okay, print instrument. So this list of instruments, I'm selecting an instrument from it. This is just a name. If you even put X here and you put X here, it'll work fine. So it is just for the purpose of understanding that from these instruments we are selecting one instrument and printing it. So shift enter, bass drums guitar. So if you have a list of things and you want to do something, like if I say drums, is an instrument. See, bass is an instrument, drums is an instrument, guitar is an instrument. So all these things, these little parts of Python, if you experiment it while you are learning it, that would be a cool thing. So just running this modules won't work. I'll provide it anyway, but just running them won't work. You will have to do it a little bit, like just if it's absolute things like instruments, just we are declaring something, copy it. But if it is loops, if it is something that is to be processed in your mind, if you are not doing it for the, you know, 10th time, do it. Just do it. So this was it for today, because I wanted you all to learn this environment so that you can actually learn quickly and do things as and how you want. And as I teach you, you can actually experiment with it and just not do time pass in opening the file, saving the file and dump it. So close and halt. Yes, leave this page. Again, close and halt. So, closing it. So, now we'll get to the comment section. Janta kya bolti hai, let's say. Okay, the kernel is shut down. Okay, right. Anything else is open? No, open and OBS. Right. So, the comment section. For machine learning, I would recommend Google, obviously. Google Colab is a great thing, but not all people know how to use it. INPYNB for internet. So someone has said that INPYNB is internet Python notebook. Okay. Yes, it is Opera GX. Okay, notebook even local host. Okay, cool. People using mobile phone for learning because you don't have laptop for this. Yes. Definitely, people who do not have a lappy, I do not tell you to buy a new lappy just because you are learning Python. Python, as and how, is a very small thing. I'll maybe record a lecture in my phone and show you how you can actually deal with this problem. If you don't have a laptop, you can actually do it in your phone, because even many things are done on, I myself do it on phone mostly, like, just on the way, if I start from basics. Bro, this wasn't even Python, this was basics. This was totally basics. So, I'll make a lecture for people who are actually thinking of coding it on the phone. That's totally doable and it's not a big thing. Okay, this guy, Ashwin Singh, I did not understand most of the things of what you said. Okay, Ashwin, apart from Ashwin, who all did not get this? Like, was this something? Yes, PyDot is a great app. That's what I was gonna show in the next thing, whatever we'll upload. And this was not even Python, this was just the starting. So this guy, if you're confused right now. Anyone else apart from Ashwin who have not got what I actually taught today? It was just opening and closing files, how you have to do it. Because if you do it that way, it would be really, self-learning experience and all those things that people say would be great for coding. Come on, I'm reading the comments. Okay, I'll send a WhatsApp link for our app. That would be great. Ideally, okay. Okay, so someone said ideally. Okay, we have the Python ideally too. Okay, thanks so much, Neeraj. So I haven't used ideally for like era. So yes, if you want to do experiments that are for more than one line and that are not really as big as you want to do it on Jupyter, you can actually do it here. So same thing. If you actually try running three lines of code on this Python, suppose I say A is equal to something. Something else. Some other thing. So, enter. Okay, what's wrong? Okay, I forgot to put the, as I have this habit of not putting the right hand things. Closing the parenthesis does not match. Okay. Parenthesis. Yeah, now it's A is equal to. So if I wanna put a for loop here for sum in A, so now after for you will have to put the space yourself here. Indentation, Python runs for indentation. This is again just to show you, this is not the learning process. This is why you will use this. Ashwin, I'm getting back to you. Just a little part I'll cover here and I'll get back to you. So for sum in A, if I write print sum. So after you enter once in this CMD ideally, you have to press enter again. So something, something else, something other thing. So this is a bit hectic if you want to do something more than one line. So we'll do it in the Python ideally. So here you can actually run the same thing. Supposedly A is equal to again blah blah blah. Blah blah blah. Blah blah blah. Enter for Samine. See, here you get the indentation, the space that you have to put in the for loop automatically. So you don't have to struggle for it. So again, print, sum, enter. So now I'll have to save it. That is the thing. F5. Okay, you have to make a new file. This is a script. Control C. New. Okay, you have to make a new file. That's what I was saying. This again, you have to save this, and then you have to press F5 to run. Test dot the save test. Okay. So F5. Invalid syntax. How? A is equal to something something. Okay. Yes. It is invalid syntax. If I'm coding, it was a shell script. This is a file, so I'll have to remove this. Yes, heading back to where we were. F5, save it. Yes, okay. The three things are printed. So, this is what I was saying. If you want to do a one liner, do it from CMD Python, or a better way, Windows R, just write Python here. directly, and you can do it. One liner, more than one liner, that is a little thing. And then for big cases, you write Jupyter Notebook. Oh, not Python. CMD. Python. So then you will. Okay, Jupyter Notebook. JUPYTERNOTBOOK. Hurdle, let it run. Getting back to the comments. Pyroad is a good app, yes. Viram, send WhatsApp link of how code work. Yes, I'll send the WhatsApp link of how code work. So here is the link of the WhatsApp group that we are actually doing all this in. So here Ashwin is saying you can teach all those things later on and first teach the syntax of the loops if I'll start from all this. Then after that you can teach all the big things, for we are not gonna try them now. Obviously Ashwin, you're not gonna try them now, but I just wanna make you know things that are available and what to use when. That is important. When you start Python, all these things seem fascinating. So all that I want to say you is, yes, the syntax, all those things would be covered. I hope Ashwin is still live and is listening. So in this, please set two numbers by taking input from user. Okay. So someone wants a code for adding two numbers by taking input from the user. Sure. So as in how you grow in this. So in the start you will do x is equal to input. Here we'll take the first input. Y is equal to input. Always try keeping spaces between this operator, so you can, it is more readable to you. If there are more lines of code and this is all jumbled up, you won't get this. So x and y we are taking from the user. Let's say x is 7, y is 10. So this guy says print the addition. So print x plus y. Okay, this yes, another thing, when you take the input it is always in string format. So what you will have to do is x is equal to int x, y is equal to int y. So this is a string, right? Let me show you. So this is a string in Python, right? When I do int of this one, right? This is one. This thing without this colon is a number. That is a denotation. This is a string and this is a number. So after you do this, you can do 7 and 10 and poof. So the 170 was concatenation. So it took strings and then it started adding them. Okay, now getting back to okay, now let's do this in the same line. That the favorite part of my coding adventure is I love doing things in one line. So let's do this in one line. So let's enter 7. 10, 17, yes. So as in how you grow in coding, the number of lines start decreasing. So that's a cool thing. Like, when you understand that this is the same thing, if you see, I am taking the input, I am making it int, and I am adding these both in temporary. It is the same as this, but as in how you grow, you'll actually start reducing the number of lines and the processes, I can say. Okay, let's get back to the comments. My IDLE wala part. Okay, IDLE wala part is when you press window, when you do IDLE. So this Python IDLE, when you press enter, so this IDLE opens up. You have to create a new file every time you want to do a little experiment. Type your code here. Then you have to save it with some name and then run it. For now, we have a file already. Let's open it. Test. So, and then you can press F5 to run it. So it is running, right? This was the IDLE part. If you want to do experiments that are more than one line and not so much bigger than a big level of code, then you'll do it here. Bhai, ye IDLE hota hai kya? Okay. Yes, haan, ye IDLE hota hai, Ashwin. Yehi IDLE hota hai. Okay, Ashwin, you are in using C++ and now you wanna grasp Python. Yes, you will. I am from a C++ base. I was in my 11th, 12th. I had comps already. Even I went from C++ to Python, and that is a good thing because if you know C++, you know what is happening behind the print function. Behind the print function, actually, it is a cout statement. It is a logo and all those things. I'm currently listening. Okay, what else do you have? Explain for in next time. Yeah, sure, I'll explain for in. The form just to show you where you'll use what and all how all those things work. Also, I'll tell you or I'll suggest you join the group link I have given. So you can actually text there anytime. I'm online most of the time and my friends are too online. Integrated development and learning environment. Yes, Neeraj, thanks for the big abbreviation. It's pre-built Python IDE which comes with, yes, it comes with Python. This wasn't installed differently. When you install Python from python.org, it comes pre-installed. Yes, IDL is not recommended. It is hectic to code. So we are going to use Visual Studio Code, what I showed you before. Visual Studio Code. This we are going to use. Let me show you. Visual Studio Code. Where is Visual Studio Code? Okay. Apps. I think my PC is not remembering things now. Okay, let me install it again if it's not present. I think I removed it or something. Let's see. Yes, run it. Yes, I accept all the things you said. Create a desktop icon. Okay, let's install. Okay, since I'm in FYIT C, okay, C is a great language. Okay, so Jupyter is the best option, right? Yes, Jupyter is the best option because you can do all those things. You can do one-liners, more than one-liners, and big codes in Jupyter. So Jupyter is great for launch Visual Studio Code. So that's a great thing. We installed Visual Studio 2, so you can see how to install it. It is installed, and here you can actually have some benefits of using a professional IDLE. So this IDLE is professional, I can say. So print, if you write anything here, shift enter, and you will see the output right here. Shift enter. Okay. See? Right here. You will see the output right there. So that was from the Visual Studio side. This I'll explain this whole thing the next time. I just wanted you to know what you're gonna use and why you're gonna use those things. For most of the time, we are gonna use Visual Studio Code only. Yes, I'll show you how to actually use that too. Back to the comments. Also in Visual Studio Code, let me. I think while you are using OBS, the apps aren't shown or there is something. I reinstalled it again, but okay, I'll see what is wrong with this thing. Next step. Let's sort this and quit this. Okay, back to comments. CMD is just for opening Jupyter or Python files, right? CMD is for opening Python command prompt, that is the Python terminal, you can say. Also Jupyter, yes, you can open it, the Jupyter from it. Visual Studio is a bit heavy on systems. No, Visual Studio is a bit heavy on systems, I don't think so. It is alright for normal systems too. I myself use Atom actually, ATOM, I'll give a link, ATOM.io, Atom.io. So this link is actually for the Atom, ideally I use that, but because I wanted you all to learn a more, we can say professional, ideally, that is, maybe you'll have to learn something, but in most of the offices I have seen, they use VS Code. CMD is for VS processors, but for right now, we're going to use this for this. You can search on start menu too. Yes, I know you can search on start menu, but I'm not able to see Visual Studio Code anymore. I can't see it. So that's what I'm saying. There is some issue I'll have. Okay. We have a direct option of actually opening it anywhere. You can right click on any folder or something and open with code. So here we are. Also, there is a cool thing. If you want to open Visual Studio Code from CMD, you can write code and dot. So it opens up in that folder. I am new to VS Code. I am learning it to teach you a more standardized way of how to do Python. I am a person who has self-learned all these things, so my Python is like, it does the same things but not that polished. So I'll try to deliver the polished thing to you people. Oh, any other questions? Yeah, CMD is cooler. There are many such idealists as Atom, you can say Sublime Text. Back in my days, I have to use Notepad++ too, but you have to run the code differently there. Back in my days, it was a flex if you know how callspan and rowspan works in HTML. Come on, be interactive. I want to see the comments. I have totally shut all the things down in my laptop. I'm just seeing the comments right now. Also, one more way to open VS Code maybe. So this open file location. Okay. So supposedly I want to open VS Code in this particular folder because here is the file test. So I'll click on this path and then I'll write CMD. Here I can write code space dot enter. So here it is, we are in this folder and we are in test.py. Directly we can open it here. Do you want to install the recommended extension of Python? Yes, this is what I wanted you all to see. You have to install this extension, this Python extension for your VS Code, because this makes it much better to code. As you write P, it just shows you print and you have to hit enter right there. So you don't have to write the print to like, it's super easy and super fast. Okay, it's installed. And the best part about VS Code is you can actually open Jupyter notebooks in here too. New Python files, and let me show you how. You know, when you actually type anything in here, when you write P, it shows print. Whatever you type, supposedly we type import. So I just put IM and the import enter. Then I can whatever you type, it is just you know, the thing, VS Code knows what you wanna code, so it shows it to you. That's the thing, why I'll prefer VS Code over everything right now. So you type very less and experiment more. Anything else you would like to tell? I promised people that it would be a 1 hour live, not more than it. So 5 minutes left, if you have any doubts. Or rather, we can actually sum up this session today. No doubt. All the things I thought today was clear, right? Was there anything difficulty in it? Let me know in the comment section. I'm giving the comments right now. Okay, since we don't have any doubt, clear. Okay, and anyone wants to add up anything that next time I should do this, next time I should do that, or you know, something was really fast, something was really slow, any complaints, I would like to, you know, review it right now, so that in the next lecture I can improvise a lot on this. This is my second live, so apologies for anything that went wrong. Is it mandatory to write like for some in A and all? No, it's not mandatory. If you have a list of items, then you use it. Don't worry, Abhishek Chaurasia, we are gonna use all those things. This was not to teach you for loop, right? This was just to show you why you will use what environment and why I. So next time when I start using Jupyter instead of we'll say VS Code, you don't get this thing that, oh, this guy is doing something different and I don't know what this thing is. Recursive functions, yes, we'll learn them too. String and for wala samjha dena next lecture. String and for wala, okay, haan, sure, meet. I'll next lecture hoga jab loop ka tab tumko samajh mein aa jayega. This was just a brief about कैसे होने वाला है. तो मुझे actually तुम लोगों को prepare करना है कि अगर मैं कुछ भी कर रहा हूँ तो तुमको वो नहीं लगना चाहिए कि अचानक ये क्या कर रहा है. अचानक से इसने अभी इसने पहले CMD खोला था, फिर इसने IDL खोला, फिर इसने VS Code खोला, फिर इसने Jupyter खोला. You should understand क्यों खोला. That is important. मैं जो भी करूँ तुम लोग को वो environment जो है या फिर vegan से वो जो भी हो रहा है वो नया नहीं लगना चाहिए बहुत. इसलिए मैंने ऑलरेडी स्टार्ट किया था कि ये सब यूज होने वाला है. Programming means in break. Yes, programming means we are all set on it. We are gonna record the last lecture and pretty well, because last time there was a lot of sound noise, and we are gonna record it and publish it. Even this one, I'll edit something for it and I'll publish it. There is a delay in publishing because there are some issues with my last lecture OBF thing, but this lecture it was fine. Okay, Shajwan, thanks for the patience, bro. Oh, DevOps, Meet Gandhi, thanks. Lucy, sir. Anything else from your part? Or it's 1 minute for 1 hour and I think we are good to go. For today, we exactly started at 7. That was a cool thing. and all the things worked very fine. Nothing from your side. Should I close it? Yes, no. Rajesh sikha do sara Python. Okay, Ashwin, thank you so much, Ashwin. I thought that Ashwin would really say something that would hurt me, but Ashwin is a good guy. Ashwin Singh, thanks, bro. Thanks for teaching, all good. You were great both lectures. Oh, thank you, Seja. Shah Nawaz. Nice, bro. See ya. Okay, guys, if more doubts, you can text. Yes, you can text in the group. I have already sent the link, but I'll send it once more. So this is the group to the, this is the link to the group, and you can anytime text there. There is me and my friends. We can actually solve any doubt of yours anytime you want. Okay, see you next time. Sayonara. Thanks, people. Bye. Thank you.